As of 1 p.m. today, the Kingdom of Arugia has declared war on the Ocean Federation. As soon as the news broke out, enemy aircraft began bombing Ocean territory, causing widespread destruction. The Air Defense Force has released a statement saying this violent attack was carried out by drones. They speculate the drones were secretly transported to Ocea in shipping containers and launched remotely. The Secretary of the Navy has stated that the enemy was targeting naval ports across the country. According to the Secretary, all of the nation's aircraft carriers, including one still under construction, sustained severe damage in the attacks. We have yet to hear back from the department as to the fate of Ocean carriers currently at sea. Hold on. I've just received breaking news. The International Space Elevator, which is being built in southern Yuzha, has been seized by the Arugian Army. Reports say former President Harling was touring the site at the time, but his current whereabouts are unknown. Our sources in government tell us it was Harling's policies regarding the space elevator that caused economic frictions in the area, and which ultimately led to this war. Located near Arugia, on the continent of Yuzha, the space elevator has been under construction for some time now. The Executive Office of the Ocean Federation has declared a national state of emergency. They have ordered all its armed forces, including Yuzhan peacekeepers, to mobilize and make the necessary preparations to launch an immediate counterattack. Ladies and gentlemen, our country is officially at war. Stay tuned for further updates.
Breaking news from ENN. Ocea launched an attack on the capital today, striking Farbanti from their aircraft carrier, the Kestrel II. After a brutal battle, the Arugian Air Force successfully repelled them. During the air raid, the Ocean Air Force fired missiles at the city and managed to shoot down a number of Arugian fighters. Some of the disabled planes then crashed into residential areas.
The world was screwed. 20 years ago, the Earth got slammed by an asteroid. Yuzha was on the wrong side of the planet and got hit. Hard. Refugees swarmed the Arugian Republic, the biggest country on the continent, plunging it into chaos. They were desperate and started a war, one they had no hope of winning. That's the war my dad fought and died in. The biggest nations from two continents went head to head, and the so-called righteous Oceans struck the deal that ended it. They fancied themselves the only nation that could bring peace and stability to the world. They even tried saving the Yuzhans, still suffering from the disaster. That's how a space elevator, stretching way up into the sky, ended up being built in Yuzha, paid for by the Oceans. President Harling said he did it out of compassion for his fellow humans. But to the folks in Arugia, it looked like Ocea was moving in to take over. Arugia went from being a republic back to being a kingdom. When they started this new war, they managed to get the drop on everyone. The second the declaration hit the news, Arugian forces took control of the space elevator without spilling a single drop of blood. President Harling was touring the elevator when it happened and disappeared. Then, while that was going on, the Arugian ships that were docked all around Ocea released a swarm of drone fighters they had hidden on board in containers. No one thought they were capable of doing what they did that day. With pinpoint accuracy, they managed to take out everything that was military, and not a single civilian was hurt in the process. Ocea pissed lots of people off with their huge military presence around the world. Arugia didn't have the same reach, but they could hit their targets faster and cleaner. And when all this was going down, I just so happened to be in my flying drag racer. In case you were wondering, yeah, I survived. I crashed in a bombed-out Ocean Air Force base, then got arrested for breaking wartime aviation laws or some crap. The world went from being at peace to being at war, all in the blink of an eye.
I'm Princess Rosa Cassette Delise of the Kingdom of Arugia. Today, Ocean airstrikes have shattered the lives of countless Arugians. The attacks practically leveled the school I went to. It is heartbreaking. Tragic.
I was tried, found guilty, and stuffed into a cargo ship. For company, I had some court-martialed soldiers. And remember those mothballed planes I told you about before? They were loaded on the ship, too. We headed off down south for several days, and then swung east. That's how I got here. I was thousands of kilometers from Arusia, on the opposite side of the Usian continent. For a port, it was dull as hell. It had three rusty patrol boats. And the base? The fences were topped with razor wire, the tower had a searchlight and machine guns, and a truck with a gun turret was parked in front of the gate. Its gun was aimed at the yard. This was a prison. This place looked like a full-on base, but half the tanker trucks were just big balloons, and the runways weren't even paved, just painted on the dirt. The whole place was just one big fat lie. The only reason I was here is because they knew I'd restored a supersonic plane. They wanted me to make something out of the mothballed planes they brought, that they could park on the fake runway. Can you believe that shit? So, I tried to escape. They found out and set the dogs on me.
Arusia has made a declaration to the Ocean Federation and all countries on the Usian continent stationing the IUN peacekeeping force that we are now at war. Right after the declaration was made, surprise attacks began around the continent that have inflicted major damage to our armed forces. Forces aligned with Arusia are currently appearing throughout Usia. The combination of these forces has overwhelmed the majority of the continent, and they are now encroaching on us in the east. Additionally, the multinational space elevator has been seized by the Arusian military. After the previous war, the space elevator became both a symbol of peace and a valuable asset in the fight against growing energy concerns. Whoever has control of it will have enormous influence over the entire continent. We cannot turn a blind eye to this critical situation. The Fort Gray's Air Base Squadron has been entered into the order of battle to reclaim the elevator as an advanced element. First, you will attack all hostiles coming in the east of Schofield Plateau to stop any interference with the Allied ground troops. The enemy has deployed several vehicles equipped with anti-air radar along the roads. You are to destroy them. They should not pose much of a threat. However, there is a high likelihood that the attack will draw more enemy air support. If that happens, fight them off swiftly and establish air superiority.
Rescue Squadron, sorting ASAP.
Target is on rails, but there's still military vehicles and anti-air weaponry. Destroy the target. But HQ has made it clear that no harm should come to civilians and no damages to be done to public facilities.
But, any aircraft shot down could land in civilian territory.
No point arguing. That's how war is these days.
Do you have visual on the anti-air radar vehicles? They should be close.
Yep.
Caution. Pull up.
As of 1 p.m. today, the Kingdom of Arugia has declared war on the Ocean.
The world was screwed. 20 years ago, the Earth got slammed by an asteroid. Yuzha was on the wrong side of the planet and got hit. Hard. Refugees swarmed the Arugian Republic, the biggest country on the continent, plunging it into chaos. They were desperate and started a war. One they had no hope of winning. That's the war my dad fought and died in. The biggest nations from two continents went head to head, and the so-called righteous Oceans struck the deal that ended it.
Squadron, sorting ASAP.
Current target is on rails, but there's still military vehicles and anti-air weaponry. Destroy the target. But HQ has made it clear that no harm should come to civilians and no damages to be done to public facilities.
But, any aircraft shot down could land in civilian territory.
No point arguing. That's how war is these days.
Visual on the anti-air radar vehicles? They should be close.
Yep.
We're using the containers now.
Brandon is in my sights.
Target is on rails, but there's still military
missiles and anti-air weaponry. Destroy the target. But HQ has made it clear that no harm should come to civilians and no damage is to be done to public facilities.
But, any aircraft shot down could land in civilian territory.
No point arguing. That's how war is these days.
Do you have visual on the anti-air radar vehicles? They should be close.
Yep.
Target is in range of guns. Target destroyed.
Intercept! Fire the AA! Get the radar vehicle out of there!
It's popping off now, Trigger. The war has officially begun.
Target is on rails. There's still military vehicles and anti-air weaponry. Destroy the target. But HQ has made it clear that no harm should come to civilians and no damage is to be done to public facilities.
But, any aircraft shot down could land in civilian territory.
No point arguing. That's how war is these days.
Do you have visual on the anti-air radar vehicles? They should be close.
Yep.
Target is on rails, but there's still military vehicles and anti-air weaponry. Destroy the target. But HQ has made it clear that no harm should come to civilians and no damage is to be done to public facilities.
But, any aircraft shot down could land in civilian territory.
No point arguing. That's how war is these days.
Do you have visual on the anti-air radar vehicles? They should be close.
Yep.
discretion. Enemy interceptors inbound. Prepare to engage in 30 seconds.
Wilco, here they come. Take them down.
Nicole.
Okay, recruits. Pay attention to who's on what side. Nicole. The newest IFF is connected to our entire force via satellites. It's reliable, so trust your radars.
Two targets remaining. Radar vehicle. Great work. Radar vehicle's destroyed, but the interceptor shows no sign of retreating. Take it out. Continue with the mission. Crush as many as you can.
Manual.
Nicole.
residential area.